Okay, so here we have this problem, and this time we do have a degree higher in the numerator than we do in the denominator. So in this particular case, we are going to have to do long division. So let's set up our side work for that long division. So we have x goes into 2x squared or 2x cubed 2x times. So then we distribute this and we get 2x cubed minus 16x squared minus 40x, and then we change all of the signs and this cancels, and I get x plus 20. Now this degree is higher, so I can't continue. We're gonna stop. So what that means is that this fraction can be written as 2x plus x plus 20 over x squared minus 8x minus 20. Now 2x is not a big deal to integrate. However, this fraction is going to be a problem to integrate. So if we do the partial fraction decomposition, it has to be done just on this part. So again, more side work. If I factor that denominator, it will be 20 is 2 and 10. 10 would have to be negative and 2 positive so that it multiplies to give me negative 20 and combines to give me negative 8. So we have two linear factors, both with the power of 1, which means I just need one constant over x plus 2 and one constant over x minus 10. And if we multiply both sides by the common denominator, both will cancel on the left. Here I'll end up with ax minus 10a, and here I'll end up with bx plus 2b. And if I set up my systems of equations, I get a plus b will have to equal 1, this guy's coefficient, and negative 10a plus 2b will have to equal the constant 20. So then if I do my elimination rule, I can multiply this by negative 2. So I get negative 2a, negative 2b equal to negative 2. I get negative 12a, b's cancel. And 18. So a equals negative 18 over 12. If I reduce by 2, negative 9 over 6. If I reduce by 3, negative 3 over 2. So if I go back up here and plug that in for a, I get negative 3 over 2 plus b equals 1, which means b would have to be 5 halves. So now I can rewrite my integral. The integral is going to become the integral of 2x dx plus the integral of these two fractions, negative 3 halves over x plus 2 plus 5 halves over x minus 10. And I can separate it, or I can just integrate everything right here, right now. So this integral is going to become x squared. This is going to be negative 3 halves ln of x plus 2. This is going to be 5 halves ln of x minus 10. And then of course plus c because it was an indefinite integral. We'll continue the next example on the next page, on the next video, I'm sorry.